Hey fellow tennis nerds, I hope all is well. I do these vlogs quite frequently now. Send me your questions in the comments below, topics you want me to deal with. Trying to do one a day if I can, that's the point. We'll see if I can manage. But if you have any questions about tennis, tennis gear, put them in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer with the help of my tennis friends or research or my own knowledge. Today I want to talk about this drink I have here, which is a nice cocktail made out of dampeners. And what is a dampener? I got this question, what do these actually do, these dampeners? People think that they might save you from tennis elbow, but that's really not the case if you look at all the research around this. I know there are companies, and I'm getting one for test now, I think called RTP, where they claim that the vibration dampener can dampen harmful vibrations that will cause tennis elbow at some point. But overall, if you look at the research made by tennis scientists or real scientists, doctors and whatnot that you can find in these excellent books that I've read, Rod Cross, Crawford Lindsay, Tennis Warehouse University dudes, they know a lot about this stuff and they've done a lot of tests. So I can really recommend, if you're a super nerd, get these books. They're very good. I'll put links in the description below. So these books, they say that the dampener dampens the sound and slightly alters the feel. It's more of a feel-based thing. The sound is number one. That's what changes the most. When you hit a ball and the ball contacts the tennis strings, without the dampener, the strings will vibrate and create a sound. And that sound might be unpleasant depending on the racket, strings and so on, tension and all these things. For example, a loud ping, or if you have a dampener that mutes the strings, so the strings stop moving so much and you have less of a sound, a more muted sound, a thwok or something like that. The main purpose of the dampener is to change the sound. That was the original intention. Now some companies mean that if you use the right type of dampener, you will dampen vibrations that might lead to tennis elbow. But really, tennis elbow, if that is true, the impact of the dampener on the strings is so small that you need to hit a billion tennis balls for it to make sense. That's how far as I read the research around this in my own experience. I don't notice that I feel a more comfortable response when I'm playing with a dampener. I just prefer it generally because I don't like the sound, and it slightly alters the feel a little bit to have it without a dampener, but mainly the sound. And the sound can be annoying depending on your setup, but I can play fine with both. And I don't feel any difference in my elbow or in my arm, and I've had issues, so I can detect vibrations pretty well now. My arm tells me if I'm done something poorly or played with a racket that's too stiff or a string setup that's too stiff. And the dampener doesn't really do much, in my opinion, to affect this. Although I'm a dampener guy, if I kind of prefer that, I'll happily play without if that's necessary. If I can't find my dampener, I don't have to cancel the match. Some players prefer to play without the dampener. They feel like the sound tells them something about their stroke, whether they hit more in the string bed. They, you know, call it feel. I'm not sure it is feel. For them, it might be feel. It might change the feel a little bit, but I think mainly it's the sound. So the kind of, you pick up that sound when you hit the ball, and if you're used to playing one way without the dampener, for example, you're used to that sound, you can detect through the sound what kind of shot it is generally. If it's a successful shot, you hit it in the center of the strings, that sound is going to be slightly different if you hit it in the center of the string bed or if you hit it slightly off center. But it's mainly a sound thing. Dampening vibrations usually happens inside the racket of some kind, with layup, with technologies that dampen vibrations inside the racket. That's generally the thing. There are people who say that adding a rubber strip to the racket will alter vibrations. I've yet to see any substantial research that shows that this is actually true. I've yet to feel it myself, so I'm quite skeptical towards these things, unless I can really feel it myself that it does affect how the ball interacts with the string bed and the racket and the vibrations go down to my arm. Tennis elbow usually comes from overuse of this certain motion and swing. You're getting too much shock over time hitting a tennis ball with your racket and strings. That's over time a use that can be hurtful. The thing is, you're playing with a stiff racket, stiff string, it creates a more rapid vibrations, which is are nastier vibrations according to the research, and they can then travel down to your arm and create problems for your arm. Some rackets are more comfortable, they have more dampening technology, they are more flexible, so they absorb some of the vibrations, they have longer vibrations instead of shorter rapid ones sent down to your arm. For example, the Clash is a more flexible racket, very low flex rating, so you might feel the vibrations, but they are slower vibrations, you have more of a sensation of the ball sinking into the string bed. While in certain rackets you don't really feel the vibrations so much, but they're there. So they might be masked by a technology of some kind, but they might still be there. So what feels good to you when you impact the ball might not be what's good for your arm. So for example, I played with rackets that they feel fine when I play with them. For example, the Yonex E-Zone Tour, I used that for a while, felt absolutely fine. When playing with it, I didn't feel like there were harsh vibrations emitting from the racket. But as soon as I stopped playing, and I've been playing for a while, maybe I've played a few times a week with this racket, issues started to pop up. Maybe there was too much weight in the throat, making my contact point slightly off, or maybe there was something in the layup that wasn't exactly right, but I didn't feel like this racket absorbed vibrations in a good way, even if I didn't feel them while playing with the racket. So, and then I noticed also that many other players of different levels, much more advanced than me, and lower level than me, noticed the same situation. So then I attribute that to the racket. I played with enough rackets now in my life that I can tell an arm-friendly racket or not. And one technology that works for the vibrations is the Prokenex kinetic system that I've talked about before in a recent video where I reviewed their most recent frames, and I'm really happy with them. They're very good. And I now bought one Prokenex KIQ Plus 5 Pro, and I'm gonna try that one out, review to come. I'm really keen to see how I feel about it. I did try the standard version, I now I want to try the Pro. And very keen to see when that arrives and review to come on the channel soon. So the dampener, getting back to the dampener, which was the point of the video, it affects the sound, it might affect the feel slightly, but that might be you attributing the sound to feel, but it's not gonna affect your elbow or tennis comfort, according to these books I showed you and according to my experience. This is my opinion. If you have a different opinion and you have research to back it up, or you just want to talk about your experience with using dampeners, please let me know in the comments below. I'm open to all kinds of knowledge from all directions. I'm not married to any idea. I don't think you should be married to your ideas. You should be open to people testing your knowledge and you discussing and finding more knowledge through that and changing your mind. Don't be too stubborn, be open to changing your mind. I think that's one key lesson in life, and I'm trying to implement that in most of the things I do. So that's what I know about vibrations and dampeners and what it does. Do you use a dampener or not? Please let me know in the comments below. And some can't play with them and some can't play without them. That's just the story of it. If you need help finding a racket, check out the Tennis Nerd consultation service at tennisnerd.net. If you want to see more of these videos and you have a topic that you think is great, comment below, please. That will help me dig out more interesting videos. If you want more videos like this without commenting below or just in general, become a member at patreon.com/tennisnerd. It's quite cheap, and I promise to make it worth your while with loads of new content all the time. And if you want to buy a tennis racket or a string or anything else, please consider using the links in the description below to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, and Tennis Only. I get a small commission for your purchases at no cost to you, for which I am eternally grateful. That's all. Have a nice day, and don't forget to play some tennis.